Learning a new editing software can sometimes feel like you're typing in a foreign language, but thankfully, adjusting keyboard shortcuts in Premiere Pro is simple. In this video, I'll walk you through how to change both basic and slightly more advanced shortcuts. But before we jump in, a little bit about myself. I'm Kyle, I'm the manager of video production here at Storyblocks, and I've been a freelance editor for the past 8 years. In that time, I've jumped between different softwares, so I've had to change keyboard shortcuts quite a bit. Thankfully, it's a really straightforward process, so I'm excited to share it with y'all. And if you're not familiar with Storyblocks, we're a stock media subscription service that gives you unlimited downloads of royalty-free 4K footage, templates for Premiere Pro, music, and more. You can learn more by clicking the link above or in the description down below. Let's get into it. To get started, click Edit and scroll down to Keyboard Shortcuts, which also has its own keyboard shortcut of Ctrl, Alt, K on Windows or Command, Option, K on Mac. You'll then see this pop up with the current key bindings and their partner tools. At the top, you'll notice a drop-down menu that lets you switch between several built-in presets. This means that if you're coming from Final Cut Pro and finding the transition to Premiere to be a bit slow, you can switch to a Final Cut Pro-based layout. Unfortunately, there isn't a DaVinci Resolve-based preset at the moment, which they're definitely missing the train on. We'll primarily focus on the lower third section, which shows all of the application tools and their respective keyboard shortcuts. Let's look at adjusting the Razor tool as an example. Type Razor in the search bar to bring it up. It's currently marked as C, but I think B is more in line with the blade aspect of this tool. There are two ways we can make this change. The first is double-clicking on the shortcut. This brings up a secondary box where we can type a new key. Pressing B now assigns the Razor tool to both C and B, and you can see that update immediately in the UI. But now that the Razor tool is assigned to both keys, we want to remove it from C. Premiere will also show a warning symbol indicating that shortcut B is already in use by another application command, the Ripple Edit tool. To resolve this, I'm going to click the X next to C and remove it from the Razor tool. Then I'll use the search function to find the Ripple Edit tool. Double-click it to bring up a blank input box and press C. Just like that, we've swapped the keyboard shortcuts from the Ripple Edit tool and the Razor tool. But what if you want to add a more complex shortcut and something that doesn't override an existing one? Again, let's use the search function. This time, I'm going to search for Add Red Marker, and in our theoretical example, we want to mark specific sections of the edit in a red instead of the default green color. So, find Add Red Marker and double-click the empty slot. If you press modifier keys like Ctrl, Shift, or Alt, you'll notice that the UI updates in real time. This is incredibly useful since it shows exactly what's available or already in use. In this case, we can see that Alt has very few keyboard shortcuts associated with it. So I'm going to press Alt and R to assign that shortcut. Coming back to the timeline, I can now quickly press Alt and R while editing to indicate that the coffee cup in the shot needs to be removed. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and head over to storyblocks.com for unlimited downloads of royalty-free 4K footage, templates for Premiere Pro, music, and more.